हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल द इंडियन मॉम्स किचन। टुडेज रेसिपी इज अ गुलाब जामुन रेसिपी। दिस आइडिया वाज सजेस्टेड टू मी बाय अ सब्सक्राइबर, सो आई थॉट आई माइट एज वेल गिव इट अ ट्राई। आई एम गोइंग टू यूज मारी बिस्किट्स विच आर वेरी कॉमनली अवेलेबल टू मेक दिस गुलाब जामुन। आई एम यूजिंग द प्लेन मारी बिस्किट, नॉट द ऑरेंज फ्लेवर्ड और एनी फ्लेवर्ड मारी बिस्किट, जस्ट अ प्लेन मारी बिस्किट। सो लेट्स बिगिन टुडेज रेसिपी। एज आई सेड, मारी बिस्किट 35 ऑफ देम आई हैव टेकन। This is the packet from which I took. I'm breaking them roughly into pieces so that it is easier to put in the blender. Transfer it into a blender and make it into a fine powder. Pass this powder through a sieve. We don't want any big particles in it, so we are going to pass it through a sieve. Discard the large pieces in it because this might cause the gulab jamun to break. The biscuit powder is ready. Now to this I'm going to add 1/4 cup of desiccated coconut. This is going to add fat into the gulab jamun. Normally when we make gulab jamun we add ghee to it. Here I'm not going to add ghee, I'm going to use the desiccated coconut and the fat that it contains to give it the taste and flavor it requires. To this I'm adding 3 pinches of cooking soda or meetha soda. Don't add more, your gulab jamun might break. Mix well. I'm going to keep this aside and start on the syrup first. For that, in a pan, I've taken 2 cups of sugar. This is going to give a little extra syrup, but you would need that for the gulab jamun to soak well. To which I'm going to add 1.5 cups of water. Keeping this mixture to boil. The sugar has nearly melted. The mixture will come to a good boil. To this, for flavoring, I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of elaichi powder. You can also add rose water to it. That also adds a lovely flavor. Now, what is the consistency of the sugar syrup that I need? It should be slippery, like how honey is when you touch it, but it should not form any string consistency. Once it's reached the consistency, I'm covering it and keeping it aside. And we'll go back to the biscuit powder to make the gulab jamuns. Now to knead the gulab jamun, I'm going to make sure that I'm not going to use the palm of my hand, but only just the fingertips, because I don't need to add any pressure to this while kneading. Use it, just gather everything together with your fingertips. And for kneading, I'm using milk. This is at room temperature. I've taken 1 cup, but I used only 3/4 cup of it. If you want to go vegan with this recipe, you can use coconut milk or almond milk too. Both will work fine. Mix the mixture lightly with your fingertips and gather it together as you go. My dough is nearly done and I've got 1/4 cup of the milk remaining, so I've used in total 3/4 cup of milk. Now this dough does not need any resting time. You can start shaping a gulab jamun immediately itself. I'm going to make very small gulab jamun. You can choose the size and shape that you want to make it. Roll out the gulab jamuns without any cracks in them, because if there are cracks, it will break in the oil. Perfectly round gulab jamuns. From this much amount of mari biscuit powder, I was able to make 3 dozen of gulab jamuns. Now to fry the gulab jamuns. I've heated up a small kadai of oil, but I've heated it up on low flame. The entire process of frying the gulab jamun should be completely done on very, very low flame. Otherwise, the outside covering will go dark, but the inside won't cook. And subsequently, the syrup won't be soaked into it properly. So on very low flame, I've dropped in the gulab jamuns, few at a time. And I'm not going to touch the gulab jamun initially because it's very delicate, but I'm going to rotate the oil. What this will do is that it make the gulab jamun turn on its own and color properly all over. Once I know it is slightly starting to cook, then I'll use a spoon to keep stirring it and turning it around so that it cooks evenly all around. You can make this gulab jamun extremely dark, or you can take it out of this color too and put it directly into hot syrup. You can see the earlier batch of gulab jamuns are more darker than the ones I removed now, but both will be fine. There is no issue to it. What I'm going to do after dipping all the gulab jamuns in the syrup is I'm going to cover this pan and keep it aside for a couple of hours. It takes at least a couple of hours for the syrup to enter the gulab jamun properly till the center and make it very moist and juicy. After 2 hours, it's superbly moist and very yummy. I hope you all will give this recipe a try because this is very easy and is very inexpensive too. I hope you've liked this video. If you have, then please give this a big thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, then please do so and hit on the bell icon for further videos that I upload. Till then, till I see all of you again, I hope you all stay safe.